Welcome guys to SRL Friday Night League, Season 1, Round 10, and it is the final round of the season, and today we are driving around Nürburgring. And this is going to be my last race in the league. The second season is starting today, by the time I'm commentating this, but I'm not participating to that. Maybe in the future if there's gonna be a Season 3, maybe I will join in, but anyway, you're about to witness one of the worst starts I've ever taken. I got a lot of wheel spin, so I tried to compensate that by soft shifting up, but then again I upshifted to the fourth gear too quickly, lost all the acceleration, all the momentum, lost a lot of positions as you can see. Coming to the first corner, I take a very tight line here, as a lot of guys going wide, so I guess I've gained a couple positions back there. Also a little bit of contact in front of us. Rob Sutherland losing control a little bit due to the contact, and I managed to get the position back. And yeah, there's one car alongside me, on the left hand side of me. So I tried to take the tight line here, defend my position, but the car, Simtek racing car, got a better exit and managed to overtake me, and that was the start. Before the race, I made a promise to myself that during this race, I'll try to be a little bit more aggressive than usually. Usually I'm taking things quite safe, and I'm not maybe defending too hard, or I'm usually waiting for a very clear overtaking opportunity. But along the way I started to feel more confident with this car, especially with the braking. It is just something that clicked to me before this race. So I decided to, why not try to be more aggressive? Like if there's a slight opportunity for overtake, then go for it. Don't do anything stupid, but go for it, because I know a lot of guys in this league are also very aggressive, so I have to be aggressive as well. And I think it's a fine line being more too aggressive and just like enough aggressive. It is just something I need to learn. And that said, I lost the position for this car number 3 as I was going for a defensive line, and that just didn't work very well. But it's all just a part of the learning, I guess. As we are coming to the chicane for the first time, everything goes well. The car in front of me tries to overtake the Simtek racing car. They had a little touch. There's also someone spinning a little bit, so I take the outside line just to be safe. A lot of contact, and I guess we are going almost like 4 wide here in the main straight. I'm trying to use all the draft, but the car number 7, he moved over. I don't know the reason for that, but he goes very slow there. Maybe he was having a slowdown penalty or some damage, I don't know. Anyway, I dive in very deep so that I will get the inside line to this left-hander. And due to that, I'm still holding my position against this car number 17 behind me. But he's very, very close there now. As I maybe missed my breaking point or went wide for some reason. But anyway, that will give me the inside line to this right-hander as well. And I'm barely just holding my position there. I think I'm now in 11th position, if I'm correct. I knew there's gonna be an overtaking opportunity after this right-hander to the, I guess it's like Dunlop corner or something. That corner after the downhill. So I use all the draft, moving to the outside line. I'm trying to outbrake this car in front of me. Going off my usual racing line, lost the back end using a little bit of rally technique. We had a little bit of contact with the car number 17, then I guess there's another car. Yeah, this is the racing car. I guess it's also Rob Sutherland there. Yeah, alongside me. So yeah, not my finest moment. Then again, it could have been worse. As we are coming to this left-hander again. Again, I'm taking the defensive line. It's Greg Walters behind me, but he's also having a battle on his own. So this time I managed to hold my position there. And now I'm right behind Rob Sutherland. I don't know if I might be too far away. I'm using all the draft. He's holding the defensive line, kind of, so I move the outside line. It's also Greg Walters a little bit diving inside, so I leave just enough room there. Wasn't quite sure what he's going to do. But yeah, good racing. Race continues. And unfortunately, I lost the footage that I had So I'm not quite sure which lap this is, but I guess it is like lap 3 or 4, quite early on the race anyway. As I'm following Rob Sutherland, and it's Greg Walters right there behind me. We are coming this long straight. I'll take the defensive line as we are going side by side with Greg Walters. Defensive line in this left-hander, it's like a deja vu moment, I guess I'm... Yeah, I had to give up my positions there, so that... There's something I should have done differently in that corner, I guess, because I lost like... I lost too many positions there. And this is again, maybe lap or two later. As you can see, Rob Sutherland and Greg Walters managed to get passed by the Simtek racing car. It's now my chance to try to overtake. Maybe the Simtek car was having damage or something. Anyway, I'm squeezed in. There's just enough room for a car in there. As we are coming to chicane, we are still going side by side. And we had a little touch there. To be honest, yeah, I think that was just a racing incident. To be honest, I had no idea that the car was there. So maybe I didn't leave enough room. But I was still quite happy that I went for it. Like I said, I tried to be more aggressive. This time it didn't pay off. Next time it will, maybe. Who knows? Well, it's a shame that Simtek racing car had to pit. Maybe he was going to pit anyway, so I don't know. Race continues still. So yeah, after that incident, I was following this car for a few laps, maybe 3 laps or something. And I wasn't just finding a good overtaking opportunities, as I was also starting to take things more safe. Again, like I felt like I've had enough incidents in this race, so maybe just calm down a little bit and relax. But then again, this car now, he brakes very, very early, maybe just letting me go. I'm not sure, but the letting me go could have been actually a great thing to do, like, for both of us. Sometimes you just don't want to fight too much. We are coming to the pitch now. This is pretty much the halfway through the race. And pay attention to the gap in front. So I'm pretty close to this this car in front of me. And if you think my start was bad, just take a look at my pit exit then. The gap is still quite the same. As we crossed the line, I thought my like pit limiter was on, so I pressed it off, but it actually went on. Then I was hitting the... Like, I forgot to change the gears, and I pressed, I guess I pressed the pit limiter on again, and just a little, like a huge mess. And I think I lost like a second or two there, just because of that. And a few laps later, I managed to catch the guy in front. This is the car that was in front of me before we went to the pits. I'm trying to do the move to the chicane, just like last time. And this time it works. More cleanly, and that gave me a lot of, like a huge confident boost, to be honest. I'm not sure, I think I'm holding now 12th position or something. And this is the second last lap, so 2 laps to go. I was slowly starting to catch the guys in front, but I think I will run out of time. And that's it. I think that's Greg Walters went a little wide. So that will help me. A little bit. I'm not that far away. And actually there's one car off track. He's rejoining. Is he going to... Yeah, they're going side by side with Greg Walters. He managed to get in front of Greg Walters. And all of this battling is actually going to help me. So I was at this point, I was pushing and giving everything I got. And this is the last lap. As you can see, I managed to catch up with the Greg Walters. And actually, this was the race when I realized he has this Gene Simmons kiss icon on back of his cars. Quite nice touch, that red tongue. But I'll have time to admire that after the race, so let's try to do something. Again, I knew this Dunlop corner is going to be an overtaking opportunity. This is like a deja vu from the like the early on race. Just not try to spin this time. Yeah, I'm still I made this stupid little correction to the left. I think that cost me the opportunity. So I knew that the last real overtaking opportunity will be the last she gained, so at this point I was just trying to get as close as I can to Greg Walters. Maybe hoping that he will do a slight mistake, as I was trying to also get the best possible exit from this right-hander. But as you can see, he didn't do any mistakes, and it seems I'm way too far behind. Although I'm having a little bit of toe effect here, but I think that's not enough. If I'd like to try the overtake, I would have to make a huge dive from here, which I'm not going to do. So that was the race. Overall, I'm still satisfied how it went. I was more aggressive, which I promised to myself. This time maybe didn't pay off, but next time maybe it will. And when it comes to the whole season, I am satisfied how it went. I got a lot of good experience. This is very competitive league. I learned to like this car, I learned to drive this car. And I think I might do some official races with this car in the future, but we'll see about that. I want to thank you all for the season. Thanks for watching my videos. Good luck for the season 2. And all the other viewers, stay tuned. Watch the season 2. There's gonna be like heat racing stuff, if I'm not mistaken. It's gonna be like very interesting season. I'm definitely going to follow it, even though I'm not participating to that. That's enough. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more videos. Thank you. Bye bye.